everyone, and welcome to the Week 22 edition of Instant Replay, where I give you my take on the most controversial plays of the weekend. I'm Simon Borg, and let's get right to it. This week, we start in Colorado, where I thought Rapids midfielder Hendry Thomas should have received a red card after only 4 minutes. This is a brutal flying studs-up challenge on LA's Hector Jimenez, but it turns out referee Juan Guzman doesn't even give him a card. It reminds me of the violent Chris Wingert challenge on Kai Kamara just seconds after the start of their match last week. That also deserved a red card, but Wingert didn't get it, likely because it was too early. But whatever the minute, a red card is a red card. Well, the disciplinary committee eventually stepped in and issued a suspension. But back to Colorado, where Thomas wasn't done. In the ninth minute, the Rapids midfielder eventually does get a card, a caution card, when he takes out another Galaxy player's ankles. This time, it's Juninho. So, with Thomas sitting on a yellow card, look what happens in the 29th minute. The Honduran again chops down Juninho with a late, reckless tackle. The ball was long gone. And just when you thought it was going to be Thomas's second yellow, it's Juninho who gets the card instead. You wonder if the Brazilian simulation from last week factored into the thinking of referee Juan Guzman, who was in great position. Regardless, Thomas again somehow stayed on the field, and what happens? Of course, he scores the game winner on a header. The Rapids would go on to win 2-0. One referee did hand out an early red card this weekend in the Vancouver-Philly game. Baldomero Toledo has no doubt about it when June Marcus Davidson delivers this Zidane-like headbutt on Keon Daniel. But I thought the Union player should have also been sent off for the blatant kick on Davidson that set everything off. And Davidson wasn't the only white cap I would have given marching orders to in this game. Defender Johnny Leveron, who has already been suspended this season for one nasty tackle, leaves his feet in the 59th minute to upend Philly's Michael Farfan. Leveron got a yellow, but I thought he deserved more. I think it's comparable to the Hendry Thomas foul in Colorado. If the sound of that tackle got your skin crawling, try watching this one a few times. It's RSL's Yordani Alvarez on New York's Tim Cahill. Just brutal. And again, this one is early. It's only the fourth minute. It's almost like some players are trying to test the referees. That entrance deserves a red, but instead Alvarez gets away with a yellow. And Cahill, well, he'll miss the All-Star game due to injury. This match was a busy one for referee Silvio Petrescu, with 3 penalty kicks awarded, and all of them for the slightest of contacts. First, RSL's Abdouliman Sali has his arm around Johnny Steele's waist, and the Red Bulls midfielder goes down. Later in the first half, it's Olmes Garcia hitting the ground fairly easily after gaining position on defender Marcus Holgersen. And then late in the match, RSL's Aaron Mon puts his arm around Fabian Espindola, and the Argentine sells the contact to earn the game-tying penalty kick. Plenty of penalty discussion at RFK Stadium, where I thought DC had a legitimate claim in the fifth minute. This looks to me like a handball by Revs defender Stephen McCarthy, who is seen extending his arm to deflect the ball. But referee David Gantar doesn't whistle it. Although I think Gantar missed that one, he did a great job not to take the bait on 3 other alleged penalty kick offenses. And to think they all looked like penalties in real time. In the 29th minute, DC's John Thorrington just goes down way too easily on the contact from Jose Gonsalves. In the 51st minute, it looks like New England's Lee Wynn is flinging himself to the ground. And in the 68th minute, it's clearly Silva who is leaping into Gonsalves. But Gantar's most controversial call at RFK may have come in the 95th minute, when the Revs were breaking on the heels of a DC corner kick. The goalkeeper was on the other end of the field, and New England's Cyrus Senn looked to have the easiest of goals, but the final whistle sounds just as he's about to kick the ball into the empty net.
Cyrus Senn will put it in the net.
The Revs were not happy about that one. They resorted to mass confrontation to show it. Chicago Fire fans are not going to be happy when we replay what looks like a foul in the box on forward Quincy Amariquois. With the score tied 1-1 in the 87th minute in Houston, Brad Davis comes in for the sandwich on the Fire player. No call from referee Ricardo Salazar. But even Fire fans have to acknowledge the good decisions made by assistant referee Brian Dunn on this day. First, in the 18th minute, he correctly flags Houston's Bobby Boswell for an offside position by the slimmest of margins. That was a tough call to make. Then, in the second half, it was the Fire's turn on that end of the field. And Dunn this time did well to keep his flag down on Mike McGee's penetrating run for the equalizer. You see McGee's behind the ball before Patrick Nyarko delivers the pass. It was a busy day for referee Kevin Stott and his crew in Sunday's match in Seattle, and it started early. In the 9th minute, I thought Chivas USA's Carlos Borja commits a handball in the box on this cross by Seattle's Mark Birch. The officials award the corner kick. Seattle would go on to win the game 2-1, but they thought they had a third in the 67th minute. But senior assistant Colin Arblaster got the offside call right. Brad Evans was definitely offside when the ball left Lamar Nagel's foot. And just 2 minutes later, we had another debatable play. Should Tristan Bowen have been sent off for throwing the ball at Seattle's Mark Burch after taking exception to his challenge? If history is any indication, remember Juninho earlier this year and Andy Nahar in last year's playoffs? Then absolutely, it's a red card. Lastly, there were a couple of crazy sequences in that San Jose-Portland match. And we're not talking about the Earthquake's 53rd minute penalty kick. No, Shea Salinas is clearly tripped up by Portland's Andrew Jean-Baptiste. No doubt about that one, and Victor Bernardes steps up to slam it home. The suspicious episode came on the second Quakes goal by Steven Lenhart in the 58th minute. I believe it should not have stood. In fact, Lenhart looks to be leaning in an offside position. But a whistle would have cruelly denied us the memorable shimmy, which some say deserves a suspension of its own. You thought you'd seen it all after that? Well, there was still one of the rare ejections you'll ever see with 5 minutes left. After committing a foul on Portland's Paolo Luca, San Jose's Marvin Chavez is set to receive a yellow card from referee Drew Fisher, even though Chavez does his best to make sure it's not shown by grabbing the card while it's still in Fisher's hand. But Chavez then really pushes his luck and stands in front of the ensuing Portland Timbers free kick, not thinking Fisher would possibly turn around and show him a second quick yellow card for delaying the restart. Boy, did Chavez miscalculate. He sure did get the second yellow, and as a result, one of the silliest red cards you'll ever see. Never a dull moment on Instant Replay. That's all we have for this week. See you next time.